In previous videos, I've chatted about the many types of carnivorous plants that grow around the world, from pitcher plants to Venus flytraps. Today, I'm going to look more closely at one of my favorite genera of carnivorous plants, Drosera. Also known as sundews, these sticky plants feed on insects. Their leaves are covered in tiny glandular hairs that produce something called mucilage. Typically used for water storage and in germination, sundews use mucilage for something else, trapping prey. Though they look beautiful, these drops of shiny dew are extremely sticky. Insects are drawn in by the sweet mucilage, but quickly find themselves stuck. Now the sundew can break down that insect and eat it. It does this with a variety of digestive enzymes that it exudes. There are a few types of enzymes produced here. The first I'm going to talk about is chitinases. As the name might suggest, these enzymes break down chitin, an important component of insect exoskeletons. So if you're going to be eating insects, it's helpful to be able to break down their shells. Non-carnivorous plants also produce chitinases, as they're useful as a defense against fungal infections, among other things. Because of this, it's thought that the enzymes used in carnivory evolved from their use in fighting off pathogens. Sundews also produce proteases, enzymes that specialize in breaking down proteins. They do this by breaking the bonds between peptides, the building blocks that make up all proteins. Proteases are found throughout plants, helping in things like fruit ripening or defense against herbivory. And those are just a couple of examples of the many types of enzymes that allow sundews to break down their prey, and scientists are still decoding the combinations that these amazing plants produce. The last step, once an insect has been trapped and broken down with enzymes, is absorbing these nutrients from the digested prey. This is also done with the glandular hairs, so they are multi-talented appendages. Some sundews can also wrap around their prey, a movement allowed through thigmotropism, aka a movement triggered by touch. That way, the plant can cover a greater surface area of the insect it is breaking down. Some species can do this rather quickly in under a minute, which for a plant is rather fast. Sundews are angiosperms, meaning they produce flowers. They're small and quite lovely and generally grow on very tall stalks. This is because the plant needs to be pollinated, but it doesn't want its pollinators getting stuck. So it grows its flowers very tall in the hopes of keeping helpful pollinators away from its sticky leaves. So that's how sundews grow, but where do they grow? Well, sundews are found around the world. The areas with the most diversity are Australia, which hosts the majority of species, Africa, and South America. The Cape sundew, Drosera capensis, is one of the most popular cultivated species because of its small size and easy to care. But there are close to 200 known species in the genus, all in a variety of shapes, sizes, colors, and habitats. I encourage you to check out the pictures on the Wikimedia Commons for Drosera. I had a ton of fun browsing and seeing the many, many species. Interestingly, Charles Darwin was fascinated by sundews. He devoted a significant portion of his book, Insectivorous Plants, to this unique genus. He chronicled their digestive ability, their structure, and profiled many species. Now, I hope you enjoyed learning about this lethal and fascinating genus of plants. I know I love sundews, not just because of their carnivorous talents, but also because they're pretty dang beautiful. If you're interested in keeping sundews of your own, I've included some resources in the description on how to care for them. I keep my small collection of carnivorous plants under a fluorescent light that is on a timer. You might recognize it from my seed starting video. I keep them in a tray with an inch or two of distilled water. Because they grow in swampy areas, sundews do best with very wet soil. A huge thank you to my Patreon supporters whose monthly contributions help Brilliant Botany grow. You can become a monthly supporter for as little as a dollar, which is a huge help in keeping this channel going. I also have an awesome selection of merch available, from stickers to hats to buttons, with more items coming soon. Check that all out in the links in the description. Thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next week.